Hello, ladies, gents, folks, and blokes. Tis I, Greg, the Warlock King. My transition there was a little sloppy. I got a little ahead of myself. I usually let the timer run out beforehand. So we're here for part 24. I think it's part 24. I'm not gonna say 25. Then again, I could check it and I could be wrong, so we're gonna say 24 and we'll see. So we are coming to the end of chapter 3 again, and then we'll be on to chapter 4, and then the conclusion soon enough, and then I'll be all out of a story to play, so. I know I said I might play Spider-Man next. I think I still might play Spider-Man. If not, I'm gonna play Deus Ex: Mankind Divided. That's a pretty good game, and I started playing it again the other day, and now I can't stop playing it. Which is funny, because I did the same thing with Fallout 4. I hyperfixated on it, and I progressed a little further into the story, and then I put it back down. I don't know. Eventually, I'll finish it, I suppose. But yeah, so that's the plan for today. More story. Golly gee, I'm so excited.
Request from Archibus for you. Here's the briefing from my CO, who came up with the plan. This is V2 Snail. I shall brief you on the operation.
Wonderful.
You will be under my direct authority. Consider it a rare privilege. We will conduct simultaneous surprise raids on two planetary closure administration bases. One is the Harlow Communications Base, the relay for comms between enemy squads. The second is the former Bertram spaceport, seized by the PCA for its suppression fleet. V4 Rusty will be dispatched to handle the Harlow base. His objective will be to disable their network and prevent support from PCA elite squads. Raven, during this time, you must destroy all the heavy warships berthed at the spaceport. Solid plan, but there's a catch. Disruption of PCA comms won't last long. I'll come support you when I've finished on my end.
System. Activating combat mode.
Commence mission. Destroy all the burst ships.
Code 1-5, intruder detected. Sharing all base personnel. Commencing threat evaluation. Target confirmed.
Moving to intercept.
External comms are out. What's going on?
if there's anything else up there.
System activating combat mode.
Commence mission. Destroy all the Berth's warships.
Code 15, intruder detected.
Carry all base personnel. Commencing threat evaluation.
I'm on standby near Harlow, buddy. Patch me in. I'll gauge the situation on your end before I jump in.
Target for termination. Approaching warship.
Estimated threat range 3 to 4. Contain the target.
Go.
warship.
Open fire! Keep the target away!
Let me be at 50%.
Sucked. I should have came in here with the dual pistols. I love how the boss always comes in after everybody's defeated.
Looks like we've got high-ranking PCA officers. Sorry to keep you waiting. I've got your back, buddy. Hope you've got mine.
Code level 4. Send me what you've got on the target.
picking up something. I sent you a marker. There's something there.
This is nice. I can just watch it destroy things from up here. I don't think I actually have to go down there. There's another combat log there that I didn't get.
That Institute weapon on us. Arcabus and Balaam have moved to cooperate. IA-02, aka Ice Worm. It's a sea weapon, an autonomous deterrent created to protect the coral. If we don't take it out, no one's going to reach the convergence. We'll have a tough fight ahead of us. Everyone's getting involved. 621. Don't forget we've got a job to do on Rubicon. I didn't bring you all the way here for nothing.
We've received your request, and it's about coral release. The message is highly encrypted with top-level security, and designed not to leave a trace. In other words, All Mind doesn't want Walter to know about this. Let's take a look and decide what to do.
Two new messages.
Heard the news, tourist. Ice Worm, huh? You just keep tripping up over the Institute's relics, don't you? Well, I got something that might interest you. Sent you a briefing.
Sorry to impose on you, Raven, but I've just sent you an urgent request. I wish we could deal with this on our own, but we've got no choice but to count on you. Take a look and see what you think.
Oh, so that's no longer a decision that's... Cool. Pretty sure that one's new.
Registration number RB23.
Yep.
Augmented human, C4621, Raven. All Mind has identified you as a potential asset to the release project. Accordingly, we would like to assign you the following mission. Following the attack on Watchpoint Delta, Rubicon has experienced a series of coral upsurges. Of these, the corporations have seized 1.6% of the estimated total volume. They plan to analyze this coral at their research bases and have initiated an air transport operation. We cannot allow the corporations to interfere with the project. Attack the Yorkin refueling base and destroy as many corporate transports as possible. We are prepared to sacrifice the coral that will be lost upon destruction of the transports. In order to achieve release, we must draw out the full potential of the coral density effect. As such, we have no use for coral that has been orphaned from the main population. All Mind anticipates great things from you.
Raven, if we're to find a way to achieve coral release, we have to take this request.
Reiterates its gratitude for your favorable response. Kindly commence the operation.
Focus on the mission.
multiple transports attempting breakthrough.
Damn it. We've been spotted. Just to get one transport through. Sniper team, cover up! Objective is to destroy all the Coral transports. Independent mercenary Kate Markson will dispose of any transports that escape the combat zone. Just be aware that she also has her limits.
Enemy attack! 118! They want the Coral! Defend the transport!
Take care to remain clear of any Coral combustion events that occur.
AP at 50%. Repair kits remaining.
We have detected more transports attempting liftoff. Dispose of them. It seems you're finished here. Wait. Transport detected below the cliff. Investigate immediately.
THC. It's coming from above.
State Liberation Front?
The Rubicon is what risks burning the coral. Who's behind this?
Multiple targets confirmed. Ensure that you eliminate them all.
You're losing them. Where's our backup?
They never screamed at a pilot of PCA machine, pal.
Messages.
Raven, there's something that troubles me about Omind. I've been looking for information on Kate Markson, and there's nothing. Is she another asset to the Release Project? Here's the briefing.
Raven, we have a mission we'd like you to take on. The objective is to defend the Gallia Dam complex in the Bellius region. Archibus has been stepping up pressure on the Rubiconians while fighting the PCA. They must be laying the groundwork to take effective control over the entire planet. They've dispatched two high-ranking independent mercenaries to raid the dam. You'll need to be ready to take on both ACs at once, Aster Crown and Umbrox. As you know, we have few cards to play. I hope we can count on you.
Against two of the arena's top performers. Make sure you're ready for this, Raven.
Main system, activating combat mode.
Let's get started, Raven. Master Crown's pilot, Callsign King, has an 89.6% mission success rate. His reputation for finesse is such that he's advertised as the ideal mercenary. Umbrox is piloted by Chartreuse, an aggressive bulldozer with unrivaled firepower. Those who've seen my work call him an unstoppable force.
Main system, activating combat mode.
Let's get started, Raven. Aster Crown's pilot, Callsign King, has an 89.6% mission success rate. His reputation for finesse is such that he's advertised as the ideal mercenary. Umbrox is piloted by Chartreuse, an aggressive bulldozer with unrivaled firepower. Those who've seen my work call him an unstoppable force.
There's our mark. Go take care of the objective, King. I'll clip
system. Activating combat mode.
Let's get started, Raven. Master Crown's pilot, callsign King, has an 89.6% mission success rate. His reputation for finesse is such that he's advertised as the ideal mercenary. Warlock is piloted by Chartreuse, an aggressive bulldozer with unrivaled firepower. Those who've seen that work call him an unstoppable force. Intercept the two targets.
Must be an impressive pilot to take on the two of them at once.
trying not to use the... Last time I had that dual cannon at the... The drones on the shoulder.
remaining.
Say that until I come up in there with those dual detonated cannons. Like I said, it's all fun and games until you pull out the dual freaking cannon.
Together, chartreuse.
Good.
This is more of a challenge than I'd intend.
bring a Goldilocks.
We've lost both of them.
One AC left, Raven.
I was trying to avoid doing that.
No new messages.
I've looked into Branch, the independent mercenaries who attacked you. It appears they don't have a fixed membership. Instead, they maintain independence and anonymity with a revolving door of select mercenaries. Now, it seems they've left it to you to champion the free will they stood for. Sooner or later, you'll have to make a choice no one can make for you. When that time comes, I hope I can support you. Raven.
The last one we're gonna do, and then next time we will do the.
I'll cut to the chase.
The conclusion.
This is about the Ice Worm, that Institute relic you had a run-in with. The corpse might stand a chance if it were just the PCA they were teaming up against. But that monster is a whole other story. You can't just throw bodies at it. The thing that makes it such a pain in the ass is its perpetual reactive shield. Coral tech. Takes advantage of the coral's directivity. Ordinary weapons can't touch it. So let's get extraordinary. I can make you something that'll punch a hole in that shield. But I'll need your help. You'll be heading to Grid 012. One of the first sectors they built. And it's barely holding up. That's where a little rat who betrayed R.A.D. is hiding out. Goes by the name of Honest Brute. His AC, Milktooth, was built by us, so its only flaw is that it's piloted by him. When he ran from R.A.D., he didn't just take credits in tech. He also took a secret project of mine. And that secret project is what we'll need to bust open the Ice Worm shield.
Main system activating combat mode.
So we're just gonna fly through this.
All right, tourist. I'll tell you where to go.
visitor from so far away.
We're here to take back what you stole from us.
Make sure you keep clear of the laser sensors. They're set to activate the enemy machines.
A new friend from afar, just for me. What joy. Be still, my beating heart.
Two repair kits remaining.
I'm waiting for you, friend. Fidgeting anxiously before the big dance. I do hope I'll keep on fighting. Anticipation is part of the fun.
I gave them the heavy warship fleet. In exchange, Balaam's in charge of putting down the beast. They also offered some top Vespers. Guess they don't trust us.
Better than nothing. I'll provide what support I can, too.
Yeah, your mad scientists, R.A.D. or whatever, and that hound of yours.
Michigan, don't underestimate 621. That hound always delivers.
Messages.
This is Chatty Stick, R.A.D. Thanks for putting down Brute. The Chief's already in the workshop tweaking the rail cannon. And I've never seen her happier to be at work. That is all. Later, tourist.
Time for work, 621. This next mission's all or nothing. Make sure you attend the briefing.
Wonderful. Alright, well, that's the end for today, all y'all lovely people. Next time we will conclude this chapter by defeating the Ice Worm, and we will move into the next chapter and see what lovely story changes await us as we proceed to finally completing this story. Yeah. And thank you, number 48. Thank you, 38. And may peace be with you all and all that happy jazz.